iOS 12 is here and finally available for everyone. You don't need a developer account, simply go to Settings, General and Software Update to download and install iOS 12. In this iOS 12 hands-on tutorial, I'll show you 10 iOS 12 settings that you should change right now. Hello everyone, I'm Rahul from TechRepo, and if you have just upgraded to iOS 12, change these iOS 12 settings right now. Until now, one of the biggest security flaws in almost every iPhone was USB debugging. Brute force USB unlocking tools like Grayshift could easily get past the lock screen by entering an unlimited number of guesses. But thanks to iOS 12, now you have got USB restricted mode. Simply go to Settings, then Face ID. If you have older iPhones without Face ID, this will be Touch ID and Passcode. Now scroll all the way down until you find USB accessories. Make sure this is turned off. If this is turned on, this will allow access to your iPhone even if your iPhone is locked. However, just by turning it off, you can make your iPhone a lot more secure against potential vulnerabilities. If you go to Settings, then Privacy, you will find Location Services. Tap on it and scroll all the way down to the bottom. Here you will find System Services. It's important to understand these arrows as they indicate how they are using your location. For example, a hollow arrow indicates that an app may receive your location under certain conditions. A purple arrow indicates that it has recently used your location. However, a gray arrow indicates that an app has used your location in the past 24 hours. Now that you understood, proceed to System Services. And here you will see significant locations to be on by default. Now let me tell you what is significant locations on your iPhone. Significant locations is the setting that lets Apple record a list of your most frequently visited locations. While this is good for some apps that completely rely on location services like Google Map and Apple Map, etc., but at the same time this can be a huge privacy concern. So clear the history and turn off significant locations. In the same System Services settings, you will also find location-based alerts, location-based Apple ads, and location-based suggestions. By default, all these three will be turned on, which means your iPhone is sharing location-based data to help Apple better target you with their advertising. While this might not be a big deal for normal users, but if you are a privacy buff, why would you allow Apple to track your location and use it to their advantage? Turn all these three settings off and let Apple marketing team do their work. After all, they are getting paid for it. Now that we are talking about ads, how about limiting ad tracking on your iPhone? As you know, ad marketplaces like Google, Facebook, etc. target you with ads based upon your interest. Which means if you like iPhone XS, you are more likely to see ads about it everywhere. To limit ad tracking, go to Settings, then Privacy. Scroll down to the bottom and tap on Advertising. Here you will see an option to limit ad tracking. By default, it will be turned off. Turn it on and this will limit ad tracking. While this may not completely block ads on your iPhone, but this is definitely going to show you ads that are less targeted to your interest. Furthermore, you can also enhance ad tracking limit in Safari. Go to Safari in Settings and scroll down to Privacy and Security. Here you will need to turn it on, which will ask websites to not track you when browsing in Safari web browser. Now go to Settings, then Privacy, and scroll all the way down to the Analytics. Here you will see many ways your iPhone is sharing analytics of device usage behavior. This data is shared on your consent to help Apple improve its apps and services. If you are curious, here is all the data my device has shared with Apple developers so far. Well, this was because I am enrolled in Apple developer program. And now that beta is over, I no longer want to share my iPhone analytics and other data with Apple developers. So I would simply turn off all these one by one. Of course, this is also going to improve iPhone battery life, as my device would be sending less data in the background. By default, lock screen widgets are enabled in iOS 12, which means even if your iPhone is locked, anyone can slide left and scroll to view sensitive content like which apps you frequently use, alarm time, notes, reminder, calendar events, and many more for which you have added a widget. This is a huge risk to your privacy. To turn it off from showing and avoid potential breach in your privacy, simply tap on Edit located at the bottom and remove the one which holds more sensitive data. And once done, tap on Done to confirm. You could also completely disable widgets from lock screen so that no one can access any information. To do so, go to Settings, then Face ID and Passcode, and scroll all the way down to bottom. Here you will need to turn off Today View to disable access when locked, and this will completely remove widgets from the lock screen. If you go to Settings and then to Privacy, you will see the option for camera access. Tap on it and it will show you a list of apps that have requested access to your camera. Messaging apps like Telegram or WhatsApp with camera access are good for video calling. But if you see an app that should not have your camera access, simply disable that. Now your iPhone is more secure. Same can be true with microphone access. Not all apps are required to have your microphone access. If there is any you find not appropriate, simply turn off microphone access for that app. And now your iPhone is even more secure. Now, if you go to Settings, then Privacy, tap on Location Services. Here is a very useful feature, which is Share My Location. This basically helps you share your location with friends, family, and loved ones. Of course, both parties need to agree by requesting and allowing location sharing. But this can be evil sometimes, as someone can use it to your disadvantage and spy against you. If you want to avoid the risk of tracking your iPhone without your permission, simply turn it off. Finally, we have something related to Control Center. As you might already know, customize your Control Center is the greatest gift of iOS 11. But even after iOS 12 upgrade, there are some security flaws with Control Center. For example, if you have added shortcuts for Notes app in the Control Center, then anyone can easily access it even if your device is locked. Though it requires password when trying to access other notes previously taken, yet it might be inconvenient to allow anyone to add anything in your notes. To avoid such risk completely, you can either remove apps like Apple Notes for Control Center or completely disable access to Control Center from lock screen. Go to Settings, then scroll down to Face ID and Passcode. Again, if you have an older iPhone, this will be Touch ID and Passcode. Tap on it and scroll down to the bottom. Now turn off the slider next to Control Center. This will completely disable Control Center from access when your iPhone is locked. So one more step to your complete iPhone security. Well, these were the 10 iOS 12 settings that you should change right now. Hopefully this video was helpful. If you enjoyed watching this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Tech Repro channel as more iOS 12 tips tricks coming up in the next video. Well, this is all signing off, and I'll see you in the next video.